Yeah, it's going.
Most of the guys I fish with, or have fished with, is done give her up and gone.
Yeah. And, but you're sure in good health, though. You're a long way from that. I mean, you still.
I ain't no good. I'm down my knees and my shoulder. I don't know what's the matter with it. They say, Ford says he's got a football knee.
Yeah.
I've got two sheep shearing knees, and I think a sheep shearing shoulder.
Yeah.
So I sheep sheared all out of that right hand.
Yeah. Yeah.
It goes up in my neck. But there's just lots of guys here in Springfield and some good fishers. Three of the best bait casters I ever saw in my life was Carl Hennessy, Sam Robards, and Ed Crow. Do you know him?
Yeah.
Ed Crow and his wife have taken them a fishing time after time, and they never failed. I've fished with the main top fly fisher of Springfield. And he done just about as good a job. Floated him clear down, he caught nothing. Not a long float, I forget where, I didn't float him all day. But he handled a fly rod just about like I did. But that Ed Crow, you could lay that glass up on out under a limb in the bank, and he'd bring it, put that fly in it.
What do you think's the best baits that you ever remember? It's fishing baits, I mean.
Well,
artificial baits.
One, the best artificial bait that I can remember, especially in the river, it's no good in the lake, it don't seem to affect me.
Those pecks, yeah.
For smallmouth bass. Mm-hmm. Hitting a river run spook.
Yeah.
Now, old Carl Hennessy, he wouldn't fish but one river run. He'd buy white river runs by the dozen. But I pulled him over to pecks.
Yeah, those pecks really came.
Oh, yeah.
Really, I remember those.
Me and him, and I forget who was with him. In other words, they floated, clear down below Slick Rock Ford. And they hadn't caught very much fish. And we got there to Schuyler Cobb Springs. There's six or seven springs in that whole water. And I told him, I says, Carl, you've got to catch some fish here. And I picked up my rod and got over the bank. I said, bring her right through the middle. They're right out in the middle. And I got, I tell you, I think I caught seven. And they're nice ones right there. Way down to the lower end, there's an old tree over there. And I just picked her up and I get right over behind that tree. He says, damn you, Comer Owen, what a catch. You're going to get another. You're going to catch another. And I got a big old line side.
Yeah.
He put on a peck and he just went to catch them fish like I did. Clear on that.
Yeah.
But the commission used to say fish is colorblind. They're not.
I know.
That's right. It's this. If I had my choice, I'd want two colors, and that's white and black.
Yeah.
But there's a time that they won't catch fish. There's never a time, I don't think, that fish, there's never a day, but what fish will bite something. If you put it to him right. Mm-hmm. There's never a time that all fish will bite. I don't care what you put to him. You back the trout out there at Mickey's. In one day's time, they bite grasshoppers, worms, crawdad tails, and the thing that make dough balls.
Yep.
And they quit every one of them. I kept a rake down there handy. And this runway where it comes in, I just picked up that rake, make three or four drags through there, let some muddy water go in there. But when that muddy water is gone, they grab everything you threw it out at us. Yeah.
What was the hardest fish to catch, do you think?
The hardest fish to catch? The hardest fish for me to catch is striped bass. I ain't caught her in yet.
No, I haven't either. I haven't.
But I've had two awful big ones down Beaver Lake, and what guys tell me they must have been strippers. And they're fast, and I had a big one. Both of them were big. They got me in treetops that I didn't know was there.
Yeah.
And I just couldn't get him no more. You go clerk the front end, clerk the end of the road, you can't do nothing else.
Yeah, that's right.
We was catching this last time, we was catching big white bass. And I tell you what, I went over to Crazy Cecil's, and they had some spoons there a whole lot like the Dixie Jet.
Yeah.
No name on them. And 40s, I bought two, less than a dollar. Now I've got to go back. I've lost them both, where I've caught a lot of fish on.
Yeah, yeah.
All this big old and them baits, they all catch bait, but they're too high.
Yeah, oh well.
The fish in these lakes, you go to paying this $2 and $3, $4 for fish baits, and it costs too much money to lose.
Well, that's all average. Don't you think we still could go out there with river runts, maybe, and...
Well, they begin...
Because the spoons are still used on the lake.
Oh, the spoon, I tell you what, the Johnson spoon, an old man bought me one. And I think I've got one. It's still popular, and it's the oldest fish bait on the market.
Yeah.
But the trouble with it, it made so heavy, you have to bring it too fast to get action.
Yeah.
And one of the best spoons I ever throwed, this little boy at Kansas City made it. It's a bass grab. And somehow he let it get away. I fished with guys, tried to Jackson Holler, right on the point.
Yeah.
We go down there, men always chatting a guy named Blevins. Blevins, it was early in the spring, his kids had bought him a brand new spinning Garcia reel. And he couldn't wait for it to get light enough to show me that new reel. And I said, Blevins, if he fishes me, he'll throw that thing away, you'll be like Champ. For Champ, I seen him lose two off a big fish with his spinning rod. One was a walleye he had on a non-guesser, and the other was blindside bass in Big Creek on a lead head. He let them both break his line. And he just tightened that drag too tight and they broke his line. I anchored to that wall out there. I had the net. Oh, he had a jack salmon as big as they grow. And he just kept a tightener a little tighter, And I never made a dip at him, but I could see him two or three times. Oh, he's a big one. They using Dixie Jets. And I told them, I said, I'll make you guys want a bass grab too before we quit. And we'd go way out in the middle of the lake. Wind bring us right in on that point. And we caught every, that's the only place to caught any jack salmon and table rock. And over on this point in the brush, they got to chasing Chad, maybe some big ones. And I says, Champ, why don't we go over there? I said, look at them big so-and-sos. He says, yeah, it's good over there, Coleman, but it's a hanging. He says, you just hang. I said, my God, I wouldn't fear to hang up and lose a few baits to catch some of them. And we go over there, the first cast old Blevins makes. Oh, he got a big and he tore up his reel.
Tore that new reel.
Yeah, tore that new reel. He says, just quick as I get to hardware, I want to get
near. Well, why do you think these lakes start out when they're brand new, just more fish than you catch? Remember how the Kentuckys came on in the lakes first, and down in Bull Shoals, how the big crappie came on one year. Why do you think?
The big ones is there now, but they're scattered. All we catch is right out in the middle of the cove, you might say.
Mm-hmm.
And my God, they're big ones.
Yeah.
We, down in Beaver Lake, that's got the biggest crappie I ever saw. That's the last time we was down there. Gene Clayton caught one, he's so big, he's ugly. Now they've got one up here at Farlington, Kansas. It was a state record of Kansas. They caught it there in the lake. There's a government lake there, a state lake. We go right in there to that lake. And this old boy caught it on a lead head. He never caught a fish. Never caught another fish on. And he never caught another fish where he caught that crappie. And this and Gene Clayton caught. He'd give it to me, he wouldn't take it. But if I'd have caught it, I'd had it mounted. He was so doggone big, his old bill just stuck way up like that. My God, he was that wide.
Good gosh.
I could believe he's bigger than that man, this old boy.
What do you think he weighed? Wow.
Oh, he had to weigh more than 3 pounds.
Good gosh.
Heck, he was that thick.
Yeah.
I never saw such a crappie. And they're all big down there. They're all big to catch a buck.
How do you feel? Do you miss the river, though? You wish the river was back instead of Lake? I do, too. There's no comparison, I don't think.
It don't get too hot to float in the river. That's what people like.
Never boring, either.
Huh?
If you catch a fish or not, it's not boring.
No.
It's always something new.
That's right.
Never something new.
There's the James River and the Gasconade River. Now, White River, hot weather, she's rough on you.
Yeah.
And I went down there and got a haircut and put a cap on. Boy, I sunburned my neck and ears around my cap, been wearing a hat. White River, hot weather's rough on you. But I can show you pictures of them. One float trip, we put in by over 3 boats of us. And we got to, they was 9 of us. We was 3 days. But we wound up down there, Inland Ridge.
Yeah.
We had 74 bass in rice boxes.
What was your first day out of Iowa? Second day would have been Indian Creek, I know that.
No, no.
What was the first day?
Indian Creek is our last day. We stayed at Indian Creek. We camped up there just below one bend. You know what they call the one bend?
I never flowed above Indian Creek. I never flowed above Indian Creek.
Well, Indian Creek, it's just above.
That's a day above Kimberley.
Day above Kimberley. After our last camp.
Yeah.
We stayed just below Owens Bend.
What's the farthest down you floated?
Well,
did you ever go to Cotter?
No. The farthest down I was ever on White River was at Bee Creek.
Yeah.
And I go down there gigging. Mm-hmm. And I've got the picture of him. I've got a 61-pound turtle.
Yeah.
I weighed him 3 times. He weighed 61 pound on 2, on 3 different pair of scales. He weighed 61 pound on 2 and 62 on the other.
Soft shell or snapper?
He's a rassback.
Yeah.
Rassback.
Big old snapper or the other big.
Not too long before, now that's Albert Cornell. Not too long before, some guys run a pool hall over on Commercial Street. They was down there and fishing, and they had it over there in the pool hall. Picture in the paper and everything, they caught it, but Albert Cornett was pulling him up over shoulder. And there's that old big turtle, and he just grabbed him and threw him in the boat, and boy, they went out.
Boy, I'd have gone out of that boat.
Oh, they did. So he says, there's another down here. Slew, he says, bigger than him. I'm going to get him one of these days. So we got down to Bee Creek, and we had fish, so I tell you what. We went in a Model T, and we had 2 gunny sacks that we tied out on the fender, the bumper, front end of that car, coming in.
Yes.
Hey, 2 gunny sacks full.
What was the wildest stretch of the river that you floated? I mean, as far as rapids and shoals and everything.
Well, the worst place I know of on James River was Sturgeon's Bluff down there. Came right above Cape Fair. Mm-hmm. Boy, I tell you, your head just took you right under the water. It took you down. It depended on the water.
Yeah, oh sure. But
the water took down. It taken you right under there, and it dragged you out.
Yeah.
And if you, myself, I don't know no danger. These old anchors.
That's right. Well, you tailed.
Yeah,
got out most of them.
There's a boy guided for me by the name of Orville Crawford. And they listened to me. And if they didn't, by God, they threw.
Yeah.
But now down here above Slick Rock Fort, it was a bad place. It was bad. And I told Orville, now I said, you make them guys get out. And you walk through. And Cotton Harris, and Ralph Hazleton, he had them. And Cotton wanted him to go through them logs. Well, I went through them, but Cotton didn't see me. I know he'd want to. And Orville said, no. He says, Comer told me not to. For he hadn't had the experience. He says, you just have to wait. And old Cotton, it made him mad. He didn't want to. And there was Slate Rock Bottom. He got out and fell down.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Ralph had to be the last. Get him
telling about that.
I'll tell you one old Doc McCrum. Now it takes you down there in a hurry. I go down there, you ride it, and you whirl it around, and jump out and grab it, and it turns around, and you tail it on through.
Yeah.
And Roy, Bryce Lipscomb, was asking about it today. I've got it. He gave me his ice box, one of them old round army ice boxes.
Yeah.
And he made him a seat, put him a swivel on him, raise up the back, but he didn't buckle it over. And Roy was a paddling him, and Roy was a good guy. Extra good. He knew how to handle a boat, and he knew what to
Roy,
do and
Roy
when
who?
To do.
Huh? Roy who?
Roy Sanders.
Roy Sanders.
And he whirled old Lock around, and there's a bunch of picnicking there, a whole lot of kids. Well, that lid got to rocking. Directly out, old Doc went right on his shoulders. Water swept, he got up, Them kids just dying laughing. One of them mother says, "Do it again, mister, that is funny."
Yeah.
But Cotton, Cotton was a funny guy. He always, he blamed, if he didn't get fish, there was a reason. Cotton was a good guy, one of the best guys in the world. He wasn't a very good bird shot. I hunted with him for years, and I never knew he carried his gun cocked. I quit him. No.
Boy.
I said, "Why?" He says, "I do all the time. I keep my hand on it." I said, "Well, God damn you, you ain't going to hunt me." He's careless with a gun, too.
With all the troubles with the rivers and everything, what did you think about 3 years ago when they tried to have that Wild Rivers Bill or whatever it was, where they were going to try and regulate the rivers?
Oh, well,
it got out of hand anyway, you know.
That's right. I thought it was just a disgrace. They just about got it. You take that guy, Saturday morning, Tom DeVee, come through down here. They unloaded the boat or motorcycle, went through my fence right under signs, and they go out that way. That gate locked down there. And I'll be darned if they didn't pull up the post. I've got four barbed wire fence down there. They pulled that post out of the ground and rode it down and broke the top wire and just left it. But I'm sure it's a boat.
Yeah.
I hate signs. I hunt and fish on everybody. But I do everybody just like I do my own. I will not go on people, and when it's muddy, I will not leave gates open. I don't tear no fence.
Yeah, well,
if you go to them and ask them, they can't say no. And if he is, he ain't a countryman. He's a man out of the city. You take the, it don't make no difference who comes to the city. They come out here, the first thing, if they buy a lot, the first thing they do is put signs on.
Yeah,
sure. The awfulest thing happened here last, what was it, Bessie, last Thanksgiving, wasn't it? I've got a grandson-in-law and granddaughter, Fayetteville, Arkansas, teaching school. And they got a little old, I didn't know then exactly what it was, elk hound. And they brought that elk hound by here a Friday morning and put it in my dog pen. His folks lives at Vestas, Missouri. And they went up there. Well, a Saturday morning, there were four little boys come and wanted to play in my barn over there. And I told them, I said, "No, boys, I says, it's old and you can get hurt." I says, "I don't want you to," which they had been. I seen where they'd had things, the guys and threw at my dogs and the like of that. But they seen that dog. And they went back up and told the guy up there that I'd never seen or heard of. And I'd gone down to Tom DeVee's, and here that guy comes and drove in and come to the door and talk about giving a woman hell. He done it. "You've got my dog in that old dirty pen, and I'm going to have you arrested." He stole my dog. Never seen him before. And he goes over and looks. I come back, I went and feed the dog, and I seen the track, and I think, "I wonder who's been there looking at my hounds." And I come on, she told me. Says, "Some little boys come and told me you had my dog." He didn't stop and even look at the dog. And come to the house, she told me about it. Well, I says, "He's the guy to see the tracks over there." I says, "I know who the boys was, and I'll find out." Do you know Tom Collins, Dennis?
I know who he is.
I know he's a friend of mine. I sold him that hill up there. And it's his boys. And I told him, I says, "Patrick didn't seem to like it, Tom." I says, "If you don't care for playing in the barn, I don't, but it's dangerous." He says, "Come in time my boys down there," he says, "you make them do what I tell them, what you tell them to do, you're a boss." He says, "If they don't do it, you get you a stick and you set their tails afire. You make them mind you." And we got through there, I said, "Do you know a guy up there, I've got an elk hound? I think it's Hill County." He says, "Yeah, he's got two. And they're driving us all nuts. They've been down there having my cattle, twice. And I knowed him." So I says, "Who is he?" He told me. And I says, "What kind of a guy is he?" "Oh," he says, "he's just a pretty good guy, but says he just wants to boss everybody and big mouth." I told him what happens. He says, call him up and get him hail. He says he needs it. Get him a year full.
And says, nerve. Huh? He had his nerve.
Why, sure
here,
he
assuming
did.
That that was his dog. Yeah, that's
sure he did.
Bessie that way.
And he says, kill them damn dogs. They're running us all nuts. Well, I says, I'm going to get back in the cattle.
Yeah.
From what he's done, and I called him up, and I tell you, if I didn't put it to him. But the little boys, they've told me that he had to put his dog put to sleep, but I seen him, or they, somebody else got one. I seen him the other day down here at the picnic ground. And I told him, I said, if there's any man in any way about you, you'd come back and apologize to my wife. I said, right. God damn you, don't you ever come back and jump onto her. About anything, you come jump on me. If she's a man, you would.
Yeah,
a man go to a strange woman he never saw before.
Oh,
Christ.
Well, we've had a lot of people moving in this part of the country that they come, they're like they're that way, you know, they are. They're just.
Well, Tom Collins says he's got a brother. He's the finest guy you ever saw.
Mm-hmm.
But this guy, he gets big mouths and
want
to boss everybody. That's what Tom says. I never seen the guy. Maybe seen him, but I didn't know who he was. But they, right now, it's a Sunday before last, kids running back and forth down there, climbing the fence. One holding it up, the other one pushing it down in time.
It's
got it stripped.
Oh, yeah.
This rock fence here, go down there and look. Throwing rocks in the branch. They're good kids.
Yeah.
They don't know. They don't even need to leave their gates open.
Nobody's
they don't
ever,
know. They don't
ever
know.
Taught them. Nobody's
no.
ever taught them.
And you just can't put up with it.
What do you think is going to happen to the Ozarks? That's what they've, they're, the, what do you think of the tourist industry, all this stuff? I'm not much
of
that
it's, myself. It's this, yes, they say, no telling. I don't know what's going to happen to anything. Ford signed this bill to keep on paying these unemployments.
Yeah.
That's no good. Yeah. The people's got to live. We've got to get people to work.
That's right.
We everybody can't live off the government.
That's right.
Everybody can't live off the government. I don't know, it's, as I say, if it changes the next 50 years like it has the last, like, what in the world, why the heck for, you just go back in there. Them people back in there, my opinion, they signed their life away, but.
In some of the subdivisions?
Yeah, they never live, pay for their
home. Oh, no.
If everybody, I tell you what, if everybody pays taxes like I guess they do, I'd say from FF to Camel, over here to 65, South AM Highway, a mile. If everybody pays taxes like most of us do, they take in as much taxes right down AM Highway as they used to take in Greene County.
Yeah, that's.
You just
sure
go
that.
Through.
That's right.
It's,
I'm sure that.
It's a people or people everywhere.
Yeah.
And, well, Jesus Christ, my taxes went up to $39. My kid's little going to school, I cussed about it.
Yeah.
Well, I had a heck of a load, but it's just outrageous. Now, back when my family's home and little, I'd go to town with $3.90 worth of groceries. I wouldn't have room in a buggy for my feet.
Yeah. Yep.
Now then my cigarette bill, $3.85 a week.
Yep. Well, what do you think they're going to be, what do you think they could do about the rivers? Do you think there's anything they could do? Well, of course I think of the river, but I also mean the Ozarks, the wild, the outdoors and everything. Now, they tried that Wild Rivers bill or whatever it was, you know, that got all messed up there.
Yeah,
you think there's anything they could
do? No, but you can go down here and look. Now, here you are, or whatever you call them, they used to come down the creek here and clean it up. J.C.
Oh, yeah, those guys.
Whatever they were.
Uh-huh.
And they want to blame the farmer. But the farmer, I ain't going to take his side or nothing like that. But no man with a farm, they're just like you are by your property. They ain't gonna do nothing for down the valley of it. They want to improve it.
Sure.
And they ain't going to destroy nothing, for that's their living.
That's right.
And you can go down here and look. I can take you and show you. I'll put that fence in you. Had it good and tight. You go down there and look at it. It's on both sides of the road. You go out on down here across the creek. They just died, God, Rex Prater. He had two men. They finished up at 2 o'clock down there, four brand new barbed wires. And I got at 5 o'clock, all four of them was cut. Tom Kazee down here, they've got it twisted up to where they can climb through. And he's afraid to untwist it. He says, if I do, they're liable to cut my pants.
Yeah. Well, living by a bridge is a bad place to be now, isn't it?
Huh?
Living by a bridge or by the river is a bad place. It's dangerous.
Yeah, it's right. I won't travel through that night. If I do, I'll get a hammer.
Oh, I hear this. Everybody lives by the river now.
Yeah.
It's the same thing.
It's dangerous.
Yeah.
You take Martha Bingham up here, Sunday morning, maybe a month ago, 3 weeks or 4 weeks ago yesterday, she went to church. They broke into her house and stole all they wanted, tore up everything, tore a phone off the wall, and killed her dog with her own gun. And that old dog was the smartest dog I ever saw in my life. I seen Bob Crenshaw take her and her pup, drive right out in a bunch of 40 or more cattle, and them dogs cut out a big black bull and two black two-year-old steers. Drove them out of that pasture and taking them clear to his house, which I'm going to say is right at a mile.
And that's one of the dogs they...
That's one of the dogs. She's the old one. She lives 300 yards from the creek. It's right there west of the power plant, up on the hill up there.
Well, left.
Now she sends that old dog down there on Sunday morning to get her paper. They throw a paper and that old dog go down there and get it. She minded her. She minded her more than most parents' kids. The last trick she's a teaching her was to pray. She's a teaching her to pray. She's got 160 acres of farm. It's 160 acre farm there, and she's not going to live there anymore. She's got a house in town. She went to town. She didn't like it. She come back out there. Now she won't never live there.
Well, you never had these problems years ago.
No, uh-uh.
You didn't have people dumping dogs like they do
now. That's what gets me more than anything. Is you hear these people going about killing coyotes and snakes and birds. It's damaging people.
Right.
These darn starlings, if they can hit you, and it's a sight on earth the damage they can do you.
Yeah.
And so many people don't want them killed. If you like the people in California, they won't let them, or the environment won't let them kill the coyotes.
Yeah.
But still, think about how many people's killed there.
Yeah, sure.
That's all right. Killing one another. It's, I don't know what's going into people. That's theirs. Our biggest problem is this robbing and killing.
Yeah.
Women, young women. God damn, they went to robbing like it's gone to sport.
Yeah.
It's actually gone to sport. And you don't know when they're going to hit you now. They know if Rand, if they think they can kill you for $5 bill.
Yeah.
And any man that can, he just simply, you your fox hunters, say, well, I paid for a few chickens. I went over across the creek, Irving Lucy's. Caught some fox and caught some coons. But the coon hunters, none of them hollered. I caught the old boar coon, take him down here and turned him loose. I caught the old sow coon, I turned her loose right there. They won't, I said, no. I says, if I do, I says, I don't know how big them pups are. I says, if I take her away or kill her, them pups can follow up. And they'll stay right here in every building you've got. You'll be bothered with coons all winter. I says, if I turn her loose, she might have to go back to them and she'll never come back. Them traps set for 30 days and never didn't catch another one. And they never bothered but coons. I had a big wow at the preacher over a coyote. They come over here, they organized over in Christian County, come over and wanted a trap coyote for $5. I said, well, Christ, no, I ain't about to. Okay, they hoarded, I bought traps, that through the Conservation Commission, the teacher. And I got to come over here and went to kill my sheep. And I said, crap, I fell on top of the hill. Roy Sanders working for me. I said, you go to Fox Hunters. I'll catch the coyote. He didn't think I'd catch him the first night, which kind of surprised me. But I went up there and set my traps. Set my trap. I got the next morning, I had him. So I just go over and told him, I said, Mr. West, I said, I got a coyote over and I got a price on him. I said, come over and kill the sheep for me. And I know where he come from. So if I don't get my price, I'm going to turn him loose. Boy, he blowed up. And his daughter, she got in. Eat a pound of food.
Oh, I wouldn't have.
What I mean in normal weather, mm-hmm. The best thing I can see about was went back to the diet and make inferno like of that. The Indians, they used to watch the rabbits' kidneys and they something put. Mm-hmm. You go out here in warm weather, early season, or any time if it's warm, any time of bird season, you kill a quail. Late of the evening, go into its crop and see what he's got in it. If his neck's crooked like a goose or a duck full of corn, you better look out in a day or so. You're gonna have some weather and some bad weather. Huh. You just check it and see. Very little damage. I mean, very little feed it takes for quail. My God, they only weigh 5 or 6 ounces.
Yeah.
And an old coyote, he fills up every night. As I say, if it ain't enough acres, he eats leaves. Mm-hmm. He kills a sheep. He eats wool. He kills a turkey. He hits half of it feathers. He fills up. Everything he eats tonight goes through him tomorrow night.
Yeah.
And that guy's, they're always hungry. He'll eat a coyote of raisin.
Yeah.
You take Lulabelle. I raised her. She died. She's the oldest animal that they've ever had at the zoo park, I guess, clear up till now. When she died, they said she's over 22 years old. She's 17 years old.
17. Well, yeah. I'd say that's pretty good right there. Yeah.
But I found her right on the ground with her.
Right.
Oh, well, I'm fine. We're okay. Yeah, I'll be all right.
Yeah, turn the lights off, don't you?
Yeah.
And
got to talk him down.
You take the only a quail or a rabbit. The only quail he used to when we shock wheat. You get a shock around. First shock round, there'd be an old cock quail sitting on that shock, whistling.
Yeah.
I've seen it where the birds and quail did. Just about clean that top bun, cap bun. But you go to the rabbit, his fruit trees and gardens. That's all the damage they do anybody.
Yeah.
And anybody can prevent that rabbit damage
in
his garden. But you take, just think about the things, the many different things. That's what most people want, is rabbits and quail. But everything. Harvest them. The hawk, the crow, the owl, the cat, the dog, the skunk, the coon, both now, the coyote, the fox, you just name it. Man, how can they survive? It's true. You've been into quails, the bird dog. They fly, if you don't shoot, half of them lighten trees.
Mm-hmm.
Anytime that happens, cats ain't bad. They're daytime feeders, but they get quails and don't think they know.
Oh, yeah.
They get them and everything gets them. My wife, picking blackberries right up here, she found a quail's nest and there laid the old quail dead. On him, right there by her nest. Bit through the back. No doubt they killed chickens. She knew the fox had killed it. She broke the egg and there was a little quail in it. She brought them eggs in, she had a baby sitting.
Well,
in 2 or 3 days, she hatched every egg.
Well, I'll be.
I had them in a tin cup out here. And I had them about 3 days old. And we had lots of chickens. And oh, it was hot. And I just raised up that cup to see what they'd do. But them little things look like they're wild.
Yeah.
The chickens taken after them, the other hens, they killed them, everyone.
Well, they knew the difference.
Yeah, the other chickens, they just run and jumped on
them. What are some of the, you mentioned like the quail's neck being crooked about weather. What are some other signs that you can go by in nature like that that'll kind of help you?
You take the Conservation Commission, one of the worst things is they used to hard to feed the quail. They spent a lot of money. And feed the quails, keep them from freezing. No man never found a quail that was frozen in this part of the country.
Yeah.
Nature won't let them freeze. I flushed them out of barns, I flushed them out of ground hog holes, and nature will not let them freeze. They're just like a swarm of bees. Mm-hmm. A swarm of bees, they don't even get wet in the rain. I don't care how hard it's raining. The only place you can see a quail wet is right between his eyes, right across his nose, in rainy weather. They're just like a duck.
Yeah.
Rain hits him off, it goes. A swarm of bees can hang out there on a limb. I don't care how hard it rains. Quits raining, they just turn their wings out and they're all dry.
Yeah.
The heat from them.
Yeah.
It just dries them off right now. And it's just it don't take much feed. Any species of wildlife, I've never in my life found anything dead in the woods. If you find it in time, you'll figure out what's happened to it. It'll die, there's no doubt in my mind, it dies by natural causes like anything else. But when it does, man ain't gonna find it. You can have 100 head of sheep out here. One gets sick. Before it dies, it'll leave that flock. If it can get away from it.
Yeah.
If it can get away from it, it'll leave it. It was in the early 50s, I think it was in 52, that's when the rabbits disappeared mostly. It's the year they's in everything. It's screw worms. I was over here by Prospect Church, up in the, I stood, never moved, but there are 7 dead rats. But it wasn't maggots. The freshest one was screw worms. And they was in cats, dogs, cows, and livestock of everything. They bring it back, they ship a lot of cattle and sheep in here out of Texas, and that fly come in here. Well, it's the only year we've ever had it, and it was in everything. Mm-hmm. And then they come on and put a season on, flame it on rabbits, stop the sale of it. And they just went, never.
Yeah.
And you go to the lakes, they made a hell of a mistake, I think, when they put a length limit on the bass up here in Stockton Lake. But majority of people thought it was terrible.
Yeah.
I tell you what, I'll bet you every man that's fished Stockton Lake was in favor of a length limit. He'd violate the law quicker than me or you, either one. I tell you what, I bet you.
Yeah.
You take a guy like Ed Crow, Carl Hennessy, and guys like that, don't imagine everything. They go fishing, they usually catch fish.
Yeah.
You can't make them bite, but as I say, sometimes, it didn't make no difference. The water could be awful bad here, but somewhere, my God, from here to mouth of Finley, we'd catch some fish.
Yeah.
Get down on that fast yellow shot of water, we'd catch some fish. Old Doc McCrum, he come out here and support us right up to the last of bird season. The river's everywhere. I'm going to go fishing. And I said, Doc, the water's too bad. I don't care. The dog's not able to hunt. I want to go one more fishing. And I caught the biggest bass I ever caught. I was weighed 6.5 pounds.
Yeah, so out of the river.
Yeah, out of the river.
Now that's big for the river days.
That's right, right. The biggest never caught out of the river.
Yeah.
On a black peck, that's what we caught them all on.
Yeah.
And right down, we taken out Slick Rock Ford, made a short trip, but we caught 13 bass and they was, Doc got one the last thing he caught, weighed 4 pounds.
Oh,
right above Slick Rock Ford. And back, the only time you caught a line side was in the wintertime.
Yeah.
And that was in now,
black bass was what we also call a smallmouth. And they
yeah.
call it, yeah.
And brownies. Right.
Brownies.
Yeah, but they call them all black bass
yeah.
now.
Yeah, no, that's what I mean. I was wondering
yeah.
that, isn't
but
it?
These were line sides. And back in with that old crawdad in March, especially, and you float, we'd float you lots in March, and you take down here what we call Gum Springs Eddy and the Blue Hole, and down to all the deep holes, Gum Springs Eddy, the 14 Highway Bridge, Gan Hole. You take them logs, used to be about 14 Highway Bridge. The day they bombed Pearl Harbor, Everett Herrick caught three, and three cast line side right over under one grapevine, and they made a 3-pound average. All the fish we caught, he caught them in three.
Would you eat a fish out of 14 Highway Bridge?
Not now. I don't even want to catch it.
Yeah.
The only place
they
I got...
taste different, don't they? They even
well,
taste
Well, even
different.
Here.
Yeah.
I don't even like
yeah.
the fish here. We hunted Ben Prentice Inman. We hunted near the mouth of Finley for Carol Blades. And he taken his casting rod. And the only place he caught a fish at all was worth in the springs. Only place he got a bite. Now right down here at the Bledsoe Spring Branch, you don't think it's there, it's a gravel bar in between it that comes through the gravel.
Uh-huh.
But he caught three out of there. They were just nice Kentuckys, keeper, put them all back. No, I wouldn't eat them. I don't like fish. They don't even taste right here.
No.
That night I caught the other day, I gave it away. Oh, he's the biggest catfish I've caught in 7-8 years. Oh, he weighed 3 pounds.
Yeah.
He was just about that low. When I jerked into him, I thought he hung up.
Well, you would that.
Water pretty sway up
yeah,
there.
Yeah, the current there, never know.
And there you go.
Well, man just doesn't know when to quit, does he? I mean,
well,
the city gets the big and they don't. It's always too late by the time somebody says, let's do something about it. And then,
well,
there's a chemical plant, isn't there, on Wilson Creek here
that's still
discharging
that's
chemicals
right.
into that stream.
Well, now, right, you take last year. I could go up there and get all the soft crawdads I want. Right now, there ain't a crawdad. Blow it. But it's still full above. It's just full.
Yeah.
They go out there on scenic and on up. They just catch them, that guy's sackfuls at a drag.
Yeah.
Huffman tap. I'll show you the picture. There are Earl White and Doug Green and us. I was way down there with that crawdad. You see that crawdad?
Yep.
I about hitting South Creek. 8 foot where it went in. We put it in Wilson Creek here. In less than 10 minutes, that crawdad was dead.
Yep.
You stood there and watched it.
Yep. Why do you think they can't do anything about that?
And here's what happened. Well, it's spring field. It's pale.
Yeah.
That's nothing in the world
so
but pale.
I think so too.
Here you are. During making that test, I pulled out a cigarette and they hauled it from up there. Don't you like that cigarette? You said it. That
eyes. On the screen like that.
Yeah.
Isn't that something?
Yeah. And, I don't know. It's power somebody's got.
Well, that's a shame. We've had it made here, haven't we?
Oh,
living
yeah.
in the Ozarks. And
but I don't know.
We're letting it go down the drain.
I don't know. Here, you take up here in Gasconade River. I'll tell you what I've done. It was Thanksgiving. We'd go up there. Well, maybe it was in January. Anyhow, I used to go up there right smart. There's an old man lived up there. It was my granddad in Civil War. This old man was under my granddad was captain, and he was with him. And when he met me, it tickled him to death. He says, I've slept with your granddad more nights than every boy had. And he just fell for me. And, but I taken the gig up there, and he had one made out of a big old potato fork that way. He went and got it. Says, come up here to gig fish with that little old thing. He says, I wouldn't let nobody in the world, but says, I'll let you have it, use my gig. And I took it, but I never did use it. But at 10 o'clock, I'd killed 102 red horse and suckers.
Yes.
But now this is that little old spinning Alphos spinning bait. It's a fork grind, you button on it. I had two or three baits, and it didn't look like a bass hole. There's a clay gravelly bank and logs up all about that deep underwater, 4 or 5 logs. It is in January, that's what it was. 27th day of January when I caught the bass. And we went down there, I went casting. Oh, I guess about 9:30 or 10 o'clock and gigged all night. Got up, got breakfast. I got my casting rod, get in the boat, the guy paddled her down there and we just sit out there and moved back and I cast into them logs. And I caught 12 bass, smallmouth bass, that I know weighed 36 pounds after I gigged all night long.
But did you ever fish over on the gas made in the Niangle much? Didn't you?
I floated the Niangle clear down to Bennett Springs.
Before the dams were in too? Yeah, well, yeah, it would have been, yeah.
Yeah, that'd been, you know Lou Savage?
Yeah.
Let's see, was it Lou Savage? I believe it was. Me and John Williams? I want to say it's Lou Savage, but it seemed like it was somebody else. I fished at Lou several times. But we went up there, floated from, I don't know where we put it. And we taken it out, floated all day. And well, that's when I, non-guess review.
Yeah.
I caught most of the fish.
And a little spoon, a little non-guess review.
On that non-guess spoon, yeah. Yeah. I caught line side and small mouth, not big ones, but some nice ones. We take it out of Dennis Springs. And they made me a proposition. They pulled the boat. I floated them down James River. I said it loose, but it seemed me like it was somebody else. Joe somebody. You know Fat John Williams?
Yeah.
Well, it's he was.
We floated. He went with you the day I was with Charles. He did. Floated down there, yeah. And you found that Boy Scout stuff.
Well, anyhow, they made me a proposition. They come and get me in the boat and paddle all the way, just let me fish, and I take them up.
That's a switch, wasn't it?
Yeah. And they, I had that non-guesser and I just beat the hell out of both of them. But I didn't do none of the paddling. They made their word good.
I'll be.
It might have been Lou Savage. But, well, that John, I tell you what, they meant that guy. I tell you, I am more fun that guy. I can get him so excited, the carp jump, he'll jerk.
He thinks the best.
Top water, yeah, let old carp jump. He can say something funny.
Were there always a lot of carp like there are now?
No.
And there weren't a lot of gar either, were there?
No.
Like there.
Nope. Yeah. There used to be some eel here.
Up this high,
yeah.
Were you?
Yeah, we used to catch a lot of eels spring of the year. Fishing rotten eel, yeah. And then the same. Well, I tell you, if you want to see some fun, catch one in the same. Everybody grab that old felt hat. Try to hold the felt hat. You can't hold them enough.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, because they're so slick. They,
yeah.
They've been gone a long time. I just barely remember when they were even in White River.
Well, they exist. They were left here when they built Table Rock.
Yeah. Yeah.
And when they built Bull Shoals, you see, they go and spawn every 10 years.
Yeah. Yeah. They go
out to sea to spawn. You get down below Bull Shoals, well, I bet they car down on eel down there.
Yeah.
I don't want to eat one of them. I tell you what, before Bull Shoal, way back years ago, used to go down there to K-Dock, Morris Ferry then. I got 5 on one high place out there in the water. I think it's big as your arm.
I've only seen one. Saw a guy catch one at the pothole one night.
Yeah. Well, you go up to Daniel Dam. We went up there last year. And they want to go again, but I ain't going. We did catch fish. And we caught 3 or 4 eels.
Huh.
The Gascony.
Yeah.
I mean, blow back.
But
they're just about as big as a blue man. We turned them all loose. But man alive, I bet you. I'll show you the picture. It beats it down. And two line side bass. They were nice ones. And 3 or 4 little catfish.
Who are those fellas?
That's me and old man Sharp over here. Now this one.
That's Beaver Fell.
Beaver Hyde. There's me, yeah. Kite. That's that young fella. I hope his pictures are. I don't know whether it is or not. That's this young fella. I don't believe he's going to be in there. I've got some pictures of him. That's my great grandson.
Great grandson.
Yeah.
I got it.
Boy, he's a sport one too. About me, that's him.
Yeah.
Every time he looks up at me, hi, Pat Paul. He's about 22 months old.
Yeah. Well, listen, I've kept you long enough here this evening.
Well, let's see.
So I sure have enjoyed talking about the river and all the wildlife and everything.
Well, you get back, we didn't get on the float trip, and the old boy that fished with me, my God, to tell you the guys about fishing and floating.
We'll do it. We can do it again sometime. That's fine. We'll get together and
but you let me know every time. Yeah. I'll just go to writing down names where they I've thought of several here.
Yeah.
You take old Baker. I fished him a lot. You had Charles Edel. Me and Charles, and old Charlie, and Rex, and Baker.
Yeah.
With Table Rock was brand new. We go down here to Kimlin City. And Charles takes his boat, take my boat. Old Charles had that there Studebaker Baker car.
Yeah.
And loaded off the bridge, right straight down. He got out of it and out of gear. And there hit front clear in it. But it kept a bubbling up and the trailer cut across and stopped it. And he jumped in and drove it out. But heck, it's run clear over the door of the back end.
He's lucky. I heard him talk about that.
Well, then old Baker, we was fishing around and looked over and seen big catfish. About that long. And I forget what he had on, fish bait. He said, pat me over there. I paddled him over there. He grabbed that old catfish, hooked him on his hook. And I tell you, he jumped up and he put on a show.
Yeah.
And talk about fighting a fish. You've never seen nothing like it in your life. He kept in, they thought he caught him. So we got through and everything. Where's that fish? They didn't know he was a dead fish. He just cut his bait off. His hand stunk so bad, he just cut his bait off. He's that catfish. But he put on the shoulder there, he had them thinking he caught that catfish.
Now, we're ready to go here now. Where did you get these recordings from? Did you make those?
Yeah, I've done this myself. I've got a wolf race here, but it's off another old recorder. It's a brand new one. It's the first that he ever recorded. And his recorder, he gave $50 for it, but my, it makes the ultimate racket. Guess it's real old. And then a good one.
Yeah.
I don't know much about it. Oh, damn it, I do that every time.
Rain off.
Now, my glasses. He died. Two of my old hunting buddies died. One died out in the field with me. And hope he died. And was buried that real bad Sunday. I never got to even go to his funeral.
Yes.
And Mickey was going to take us. He was a friend of Mickey's. He wanted to go. And we planned to go. And he called and wanted to go. I told him to go with us. Guy going with me and talked to him. His wife busted a tar and said he had to manage for a tar some way. I was to call Mickey back. He said, well, I'll just, you want to go with me? And he was going to leave at noon, 12 o'clock. And it's so doggone bad. And he called, told me he'd be down at 12 o'clock. We got to the office, talked to Highway Patrol. Highway Patrol, he called me and told me, the boy says that they sleet under it and says it's traffic was terrible. And he talked to Highway Patrol and said, stay off of 13 Highway unless you get that. He said he'd be here at 11 o'clock. Highway Patrol warned him, said, don't get on 13 Highway. Yeah. He says it's a sight.
Where's the sound come out of? This box right here?
No, it comes out.
Yeah, here. Well, I can move this around.
So. Oh, you're gonna record it?
Yeah, that's what I said. Let's put it on here. Might as well. Yeah. Sure. Here, I'll just hold it right here.
Going
now, this is a tape. Where'd you get this tape of a, this is of a wolf hunt, right?
Yeah. Guy with a holler.
Yeah.
But it's their way off.
says, just take it down there and go get your dog. Come back and get her. I says, man, no, I said, I wouldn't turn dogs loose on this highway for $25. So I come, we unloaded, so I come on home, and oh, it was hot. So I tried to get Bobby, and the guy was hunting me, that kennel of that red pickup up yonder. I tried to get them to go back the next morning. I said, now, there's some young willows across that road just right there close. They wouldn't go, they said it's too hot. And I think it was on, that was on Wednesday, and the Thursday I had two loads to make. I had a load to get over here by Bob.
Cut it off, you're running my wolf race.
And,
on the other side of it.
There you
will
are.
I have to run that girl or not?
Probably. I'd have to run her. You have to switch your...
I never seen like dogs in my life. Damn, I never heard one of my dogs bark. I turned loose.
How many dogs do you have now?
I've got 9 left. This old bitch, one of them old bitches I buried in the ground. She's 13 years old. She died last night. Then a woman died for more than 6 weeks. I couldn't kill her.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
I couldn't even think about having her, but I told Tom Saturday, I says, Tom, seems to you can get medicine, so I'm charged with it, and that's what he said.
Yep, I lost mine. My dog I'd had 13 and a half years 3 weeks ago.
Well, that's...
Had a basset hound I'd had 13 and a half years. Of course, like losing a member of the family when you've had one that long, you know that?
I tell you, according to Gordon, there's a bee lambs.
That's okay. Move it up too loud. Cause, yeah, I'll pick up the static. I'll pick this up. Where's your plane?
Okay. It is
crickets.
It is in that in mine. In that one.
They're running the
trailer.
Trailer now.
You just keep listening. It's 6 weeks old now.
that coyote.
Doing a lot of trailing here. It's kind of funny. The old man don't know if they got this recording. Now that race there, no, that race, the good race is on that other side of that table. And you see, that's the one that makes so much racket on the other side of that. I taped that one myself. Somehow it didn't come in here tonight. Wasn't loud as it ought to be on mine. I don't know much about these things.
I don't know much about that kind. That's a reel. Of course, that's really a better recorder than these little cassettes are sometimes.
This in here is...
That's an older one, yeah. Want me to help? Thank you.
This reel here is...
When was this one done now that you're getting ready to play?
All about the same time.
Uh-huh.
And I recorded this one off of Pope's. The dog is doing a whole lot of trailing. This is him and his old lady. Old Bill Raines. I was going to take him up there last winter. Had it all fixed. He come that first snow and he couldn't go. He wanted to go wolf hunt, take pictures.
Uh-huh.
She's big and fat, and she'll crawl right up on top of that cab. She's still hunting.
His wife?
Yeah.
Oh, she got real sick. Didn't she have a stroke or something?
No.
Well, I saw him with her in a wheelchair here. You mean
Bill
Rain?
Bill Rain? Oh, yeah.
Who are you talking about?
I miss Cope.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know.
She's that old man talking there.
What? Wrong way.
Christ, went the wrong way.
Still got her on there, though. Here, now you... There. You had her there a minute.
Got her?
I think we got her. Yeah, you want to push that one?
That one. No.
Let's see.
Run it, I want to push the middle.
Center one, that's it.
What? Still one going wrong or something.
Let's see what happens when we push it this way. Whoops.
Hey.
Nope, that's wrong. Wait, they're all going the same way here. Yeah, we'll spin that one back.
Now let me get turned around this way.
Turn around there where you know what you're doing. Have you got your tapes backwards?
I've got
here,
it backwards.
We can just, I think we pull them out. Yeah.
Turn it over and make it'll work.
Okay. If we're not backwards on the, we'll have to undo it again.
Let's see.
Just go in there like that?
Yeah, but they should come up from here.
Yeah.
Here. Now. Well, I've turned it around there and I've done everything right backwards.
Yeah, let's see.
Now you're coming right.
I think that's the way we were, though.
Huh?
I think this is the way we were.
Well, they was going the other way, I think.
We'll find out.
Now we know.
Now you see. Now I see it happened to her here.
I wonder if she's not going to even play.
What's that on? Yeah. Oh, wait, we're jammed in there, I think. Now.
Yeah, we're in here wrong somewhere. Yeah. recorded. That's the race that started. That's the first race he ever recorded. He was 9-7. He went out of tape. He went all that long. He's a big hollow. He's on the back.
They're really hollering.
That wander dog, my dogs and Colt, most of them's mine, that we jumped one right there south of Fairplay on Compton's Ranch. And they run it clear in to stop.
I got it.
And come in, that wander dog was with him. Had a collar on. We never could find who he belonged to.
Well,
Miss Colt named him Wander, wondering whose he was.
Yeah.
They still got him.
He just started running with the dogs,
yeah,
huh?
He come in. Well, Colt found this out. He's a coon hunter, bought him as a coon dog. And he wouldn't dream.
Well,
so he just pulled his collar off and left him in the woods.
Yeah.
And he come in with my dogs, and he made a heck of a good whoop.
Well, I'll be.
My gosh. Yeah. Well.
And here they all come from the west. Eating him up way over here. That's the trouble with coyotes hunting with a fast dog. I've got the, well, we'll jump them right there and run them clear to
Butler. My gosh.
In other words, we jumped them right over in the brook line and run them clear to Everton.
To Everton. My gosh.
Rex Crowder come by here one morning and says, Cormac, don't run a bull. Say, there's a big one right across the bridge, one under that gap right over there, just the side of the road, go down to your home place. I didn't put all my time and shoes. I just left them on, went and got old Topsy and Betsy. Go over there and throw them out. They come out trailing, but he jumped. He just went up the fence and jumped right back behind Rex and went back up on the bluff. And they jumped him. And I struck out, and out here the next year I lost him. I thought he went east. The guy got with me and run across the road in front of him over at F. Oaks. He liked to run over it. He was coming after me, and he met me over there. I said, I'm done after him now.
Yeah.
And we lost it over at next year. He thought went on east. But I go all in Nelson Mill. But
yeah.
And I strike out, I get across the Hawkins Bridge.
Yeah.
Well, I heard him. And I found their tracks over where they crossed the road down here by told the whites. The old coyotes, and I caught them right down there by Torrey. But they started about, it was about 2:30 when I caught them. They was going right towards Ponce.
Yeah.
And they crossed the road and I caught them Topsy and Betsy. But we all use it right now. They, just in a little while, they take out, they go right up to Sherman Waller's bowling alley. Four of my dogs run right into Sherman Waller's bowling alley. Yeah, that's just
right. Right into town?
Right into town. It's often they run into the medical center.
I can see the medical center, but running into town, because they're going through some subdivisions there.
I know it, but...
Is that coyote going in there?
That's right. The guy hunts with me, goes to work at midnight. First thing he done, he went to empty the trash. He goes out there and he knows it's my dog. He says he goes right out there and just eat him.
Well, I didn't think they'd run into town like that.
One of them just tore a toe off, the pad off her toe. And you take, I'll say after January, if you get out to one day, we'll tell them how poor it might be.
Yeah.
But this time of year, here's the way they'll do. Now they'll run out of here in this way and come back pretty close by, and he'll go out of here in this way. And he'll come back in time.
Mm-hmm.
And I just got all set. This two old boys down here in Colt, they're four of us, and a lot of other guys. We've had a lot of fun. I raised these pups. And they were 3 years old, 2nd of May. 2nd and the 12th, and I had 13 of them. And I've sold three, and I'm gonna, I'll sell another one. I expect another day, for I sent some pictures to Pennsylvania last Monday, we go with today. For he bought one, gave me $109.
Mm-hmm.
I was gonna pay the
freight
on the return in the crate. Darn if he didn't send me another check for $9, half the freight back.
Yeah.
And he wrote me he wants another. And I sent him a picture of four. And I know he's going to buy one. I just got old the way it is, highways.
Yeah.
Any way they go, they've got to cross highways.
Yeah.
And I've got good dogs, and everybody knows it. I've got a lot of buyers, and I don't blame anybody. If I turn them out, if they go into Wilson Creek Park, they go to Springfield Lake, they go across Springfield Lake, jump the cotton.
Crossing a lot of highways, aren't they?
Yeah. And they're dangerous highways.
Yeah.
Up in Polk County, they crossed 123 right smart, but we've never had a double kill on them. And 32. Now, over on 13, that old dog that barks, an old ragged man, he got killed on 13 this last fall. But we won't run back in there, but Colt old, he wasn't able to go, and he turned him out, and that's what happened.
Yeah.
He got dog killed.
Well. Well, it's too bad that everything has to bunch up so much, doesn't it?
That I don't know. I guess it's better, but there's lots of things
we can do. I don't know. I think we've lost a lot. I really do. Everybody does. Everybody's lived here all their life.
Yeah.
Is sad about a lot of the changes.
But still, I don't think they want to go back.
Oh, some ways, yeah.
Well, in a lot of ways. A lot of ways. You bet.
Oh, these are a lot of good people moving here, Comer, but it's just the fact there's a lot of people. That's all.
That's right. We've got a lot of good people.
But there's just too many of us. Well, you, take this, now,
you take this old man, now he read that story in that magazine. He takes that magazine, and he wrote me a letter. He said, I have a good little town here, I've seen him, he wants to know if I'd sell a hat. I told him I would, sent the pictures, let him pick the one he wanted. And I done the same thing with a litter mate's story. He wants another one, and I said, sell it just like I sold the other. I know he's going to buy one. And I never expected to pay for it.
Yeah. Well, that's right.
But I told him the truth about it.
Yeah.
His rights are fine. He wrote me a letter here a week before last and says he gets what he wants. And I'm going to send him another if he's good. Letter made to her. And I recommended it to him. I says, well, there's a dog. I says, I'll recommend this is good or better. She's just as good, if anything. She's better. Five other dogs didn't beat you. This dog ain't got no bad hands. Anybody can catch them. And that's what I've always liked, but it's gone to where I want them a little bit shot.
Yeah.
For my dogs, if they any car they see, they get out of the road.
Yeah.
Even me, out of the road they get.
Yeah. Well, that's
raised in a pen, that's right.
Yeah. Yeah.
This bitch that I recommended, she's more apt to get hit on the highway than her dog than not. But she's a beautiful bitch.
Yeah.
A little bit bigger than the other one, a big bitch. And I'm taking a picture of her. I've got a little of a picture, and I know she's the one who's going to
pick
her. He's kind of parked before the picture.
Yeah.
I hope he does, but they've got plural sisters, litter mates, anybody outruns him. You'll be surprised, and I will be.
I've stayed so long here, didn't plan to keep this long, enjoyed hearing those tapes.
I'd have had some good. Now, I tell you, when you lose all your buddies, you don't enjoy it like you used to.
That's right.
It just ain't in what you used to
do.
I named these dogs. These dog pups, I named them after them three guys. One dog I named him Dandy, that's Pope, Butt, and Woody, that's what I named my dogs. The guys are.
How many
How many dogs you have right now?
I just got six.
Yeah.
But then,
there you go.
There he is. Look at that.
Oh, he's holding his paw up, isn't he?
Yeah, that's... I'm on that. I better not run in. He might get in the fence. Come on, Bunt. Here. Come on. I'm afraid he's getting the fence. I know what I mean. I'll put him in the pit. Come on, boy. That's over Saturday. And I didn't hear much of it.
Yeah.
Hell, you know, come here, Bunt. Come on, boy. Come on.
Oh, he's a pretty one.
Here. Come on. Get in here. Get in there.
Let me get out of his way.
Yeah, yeah. Get in there. There you go. Jump too.
Yeah.
Turn back. Them bastards. Come down here, Tom Disease, couldn't hear a bar. I couldn't hear a bar. Come to give up. I went all over the park. Sit down there, shut up. And them little bastards, they popped up in the Mill Pond Hills. Well, I come out through, and that's Tom. And I go clear around and hunt that country all out. I hunted every, I couldn't hear a bark nowhere. And it, well, it's 1:30. I park over to Lucy Nervy's. Just start step up there, hear them bastards come from Camel Street Bridge, just eating that thing up. I went over and seen the caretaker yesterday.
See, I didn't know him. I knew the guy Schumer.
Schumer, yeah.
Yeah, I knew him real well.
See, they shipped him out and put in a nigger.
Yeah, I know that guy. He's from over at Diamond. See, the what nigger, they did...
No, the nigger's from Nebraska.
No, I mean, that was what I was telling you on the phone. They put this... This Wilson Creek battlefield is kind of a sister park, or should be, to Pea Ridge down here, yep. See? It was in the same campaign that they fought the... And why they took and put this park under the jurisdiction of that George Washington Carver monument, see? Now, why would they do that? That's why they've got that guy over there.
It's just a bunch of shit. It's a disgrace.
Look at there. Yeah, there you go. Somebody's putting that stuff to me first thing this morning. I stayed down here all afternoon with this guy yesterday. He's starting to hear a great fan there this morning. What are we going to do with it? And you know, he'd have caught one banana.
I see. Old Mitzi. Old Mitzi's rifle.
She won't be at him. They go across that ridge there.
It looks to me like they got a dog going up the hill right now. It didn't last long.
Yes.
There they go.
That dog right over here barking free, you couldn't hear him.
Yeah.
You're too close to him.
I don't hear him like I used to. Yeah. Hell, I was up rather than I had old dog.
Well, it's hard to hear him. There's a lot of racket, but I can hear him.
They're right back in that drawer, right back in there.
Yeah.
Just tagging it up.
No, age makes a difference, boys. Hell, everybody.
You're going to have to fill me in now on this. Like, what do they do now? Will they catch that coyote themselves? Or are you going to shoot it or what? Or just run it or what?
They might catch it.
They, yeah.
They catch it. We won't be close enough. Hell, every one of them will bathe in one. My last dog, she's the one that does most of the catching. Hell, fire. She just comes right back to me out there playing. You get there, the little dog got your bait. She just comes shifting fine.
Won't you stop and listen before you get way down in
her? No, I want to get over here.
Homer, you'd be up higher. You can hear them up there.
I can hear them.
And of course, before they hit.
I know what.
And they'd be right back in there.
Well, they're going towards my house. They're going behind Tom Cazine. I don't went around through the bottom. That's what started me. Tom saw one down there in the bottom.
Yeah.
And they jumped him right over there to my pond.
Huh. I gotta advise you, I'd just get right down here a little ways and stop again.
I'm gonna get a
bend
on
him. Well, shit, they may have swung up here in this holler, right? They might be right in there.
No, they passed this room. Three times going back in there one day.
Your dog's right back in there, Oliver. Right back in that, right over that house back in there.
They's further than that, Dan,
or I could have heard it. I'll tell you what I bet you can do. I bet you can stop right here and I bet you can hear them as good as in there.
Let's talk right out here.
Big old red tail.
Yeah.
He's had him a rabbit there. Uh-huh. Yeah. And what was that?
Oh, possum.
Possum. Possum. Look at
him. They come through that field there. Three times coming back in here one day. Run far above my house. One time they went out north up here looking at the ducks.
Uh-huh. Pull up, man.
They run up in here in circles. That's the day Tom saw the one.
We taking two bigger jumps, old, trying to hear them. Homer, you missed. Don't you think you are?
I want to get around there if they go out.
Yeah, but what I mean, if you get them located just about where they were, what we're doing, we're going too far before we stop listening for them. You know, and they get in and you...
They just not damn much right.
Yeah, I know it is. Yeah, it's hard hearing. Daytime. How you?
Airplanes ain't started yet. The only train used to bother some, but now...
Yeah.
Every damn
well, I think with this going a little bit too far. I heard them dogs in that strip of timber a while ago when we left them over there.
Yeah.
Them dogs in that...
Well, they
can
circle back.
In that square strip of timber.
Right. This swing on south. Hey, here you are. When I heard them coming up that holler after we crossed the bridge.
Back in there. That's a pretty good guy, boy. And damn it, there ain't no echo. The sound don't carry.
They don't holler,
no.
No, huh? You got to
be out of it away from
him
here.
Tom, maybe in there. You don't know about where they're going. I don't give a damn how busy he is, and there's none of these stops. That damn guy just simply works off.
There you get down. How far should we be from them now when you get right down here?
Oh, they says it's all, but Tom should be right in there where he's hurt.
We ought to hear them too up in here in this blast.
Stop. They could be across the FM.
Oh, yeah.
2 or 3 miles from now.
Yeah, I know it, but...
If Tom heard them, he knows what way they went. That's why I want to see him. I bet he's about gone. I didn't hear him down there. I ain't heard a damn goat.
I heard him good.
beagle's got his tail going.
Mm-hmm. That there Springer
lifting
him out. Yeah. That's a real pair. One can trail, one runs over.
This battlefield's turned into quite a town, isn't it? My Lord, I haven't been down here too long. Well, I've gone down, you know, going to Nelson's Mill. I go by here, but that's all I haven't cut over in there. My God.
This money's a Wilson Creek.
You all right, Homer?
You okay?
This would be where Springfield is deep.
Yeah.
That man Wilson Creek ship, it's been some out.
Yeah.
Heading over around Nelson's Mill, you think, or? I'm looking back down that way.
Yeah.
Here you are. They're going east. I think he'll come back. They sure held for me. Sunday. I'll show you where I turned around. I mean Saturday. I'll show you where I turned around. These dogs, two dogs, are going back. Back to the forest. I got back around over there. I never heard a bark when they was coming up. Nell Pond Hills.
Okay, this way.
Turn them out, but I hate to haul them over here and turn them loose and get in the park. Nell, far we thought we did, but we don't know where they went. They jumped in there and shit, I can't find them nowhere.
Mom heard coyote over there west of town along before daylight.
Oh, Christ. You know where I found them dogs, Sunday? I honey just give it up sitting over in Tom's yard and them Sunday bitches Nell Pond Hills. They just come out wide open. I struck out over there and I lost them. Hunted all over that over there. Give up after 1 o'clock and go back by Nervy and Lucy's. Go down on the hill and just get the poor child coming right from Town Street Bridge. So good. And they caught it. in a little old thicket down there. They made a circle in there. And I drive to it, drive around, ran over to it, right behind that old schoolhouse, south of Irving Lucy. You know where they lived, don't you? And damn, I ain't been in there since as a kid. That's a thicket place. And I turned around and went back. I'm going to walk around the other side and get back up there and stop there with a dog right behind the truck. So just open the door. This is, listen. Well, undoubtedly, they've gone out east. But they get, I tell you, right over here, they just eat me up for coming right up that holler in the boat range. I ain't heard a shit in one since.
I ain't heard.
This is Gordon.
How are you?
Damn, he's mean. You want to watch him. There's a gun on the line. He's afraid to shit a wolf. He's so mean.
Well, I got corn. That's going to be beer and dough.
God damn, how much did we look at last Saturday, Louis?
Aren't we that come out up
there? No, well, they're on that ridge right down there on that holler. What they done? They pulled up there and swung went back east.
I was down there about before you turned them loose, I was going to fetch some kids, and I didn't hear nothing.
I turned them loose at my house.
Well, I thought maybe you turned them loose down there.
No, I turned them loose at my house. And
they hit right back along the hill there.
Yeah, right in there about where I've been jumping.
Well, yeah, I'm down there.
Well, here you are. The dog back in yonder is just a barking and raising it. So much interference back there, you can't hear.
If they come through here, they've done it before.
Yeah.
I got American done it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I come by and calling you this morning if I'd have known that damn if I just brought him over here and told him that right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Keep your ear.
Right by where the wife's camera
is. Well, keep your ears open, for they're in here. And but where that's where I found them. I was sitting in Tom's yard talking to Tom and Tonka. Them damn dog just popped up over on them old pond hills going straight east, and I hurried over there and I never could find another boy. And
well, there's a bunch of them back over in there around where our horse plant used to live in there and back in south there.
Oh, that shipping things are everywhere. But I don't know. They just get to where they're throwing me, by God, the worst. But now this morning, they don't hear you are. I stopped right over there and he's going up that holler, just coming right up this way, eating it up, but I figured they'd swing back. And that's the only last bark I've heard, and so they're all after it, just eat him up.
Well, we're here, well, we don't want
him. You know?
Still,
you know? And, but I heard all these cattle Sunday morning. They must have Pete or Lloyd's cattle down in here. They just raised hell when they were here. And I kept hunting in here. I never thought about them crossing the river, would you? Well,
they think I'll hurt one while they're probably...
Yeah, they will. Louis, keep your ears open.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Yeah, all right. That's gone east. Boys, they've had to. I don't know the way the wind is. I maybe ought to go across the damn bridge here. But every time they've gone east, they've come back.
They don't do that same thing all the time. If we just stopped there a while ago when we heard them dogs, stayed right there till we heard them. Then took and Comer pulled up there. I think what they done, they pulled up on that holler up there, that ridge back where they running in that holler. And what I think they done, they popped out on that ridge and went east.
Please, damn.
Of course, you can't ever tell what one done. You.
Yeah, damn coyote does everything but
what you think he did.
That's right.
You ain't going to go back over where we was then.
No. Listen. Do it just well go crawling around.
Well, I just thought maybe go back there and they may be running in that holler.
No.
You don't think so? Well, just do whatever you want.
I thought I'd go back here and see Tom Kazee. They went out.
Yeah,
east.
But we keep on hunting Tom Kazee. Them dogs be Tom Kazee and them dogs be. They'd be 100 miles. So you keep going back away from your dogs and hunting, ask somebody else if they heard and we dealt with here.
If Tom Kazee tells me the way they went, I'll find them. But damn it, I don't know where they went.
It might might just be running circle up down that holler where that brush pretty thick over it looked like me. I've never been in there, but
they get through that bit too. They move on down.
Yeah, I know it. And I've seen them run them damn brush beds too, 4, 5, 6 times.
They run over
at
Wilson Creek Park 2 weeks ago. That brush, hell, it could peel off the rise.
They shouldn't have got away from them. That's all our fault.
No, they just damn ignored.
We just took too big a jump from them.
You never hunted with as much speed as they did. You got out there listening.
Nah,
I'm not lying to you.
But what I mean, that's true too. If they get it jumped and it gets running. But most times they run, you know, before a dog gets pushed them pretty hard, they run. The brush sticks maybe a lot of time or bad 2 or 3 times. We heard them. I heard a while ago when we got over and stopped between that long place where I told you to listen, Corporal.
Oh, here you are. You
heard them good.
You can hear them.
But of course, for a few minutes, they can drop in another holler and you never hear them again.
You can be right there at that gate and you can't hear them down on that bottom.
Yeah.
Tom Kazee. Paper East, they always come back. And that's what I thought I'd better see Tom. If they've gone east, Tom's hurt.
Yeah. A while ago down here where you stopped for that rock was, you heard them dogs right back there. And I heard them good right back in that timber, right back to the right of us.
I don't believe they's in the timber, Dan, or I could have heard them. Shit, it's just a half a mile across there.
What I mean, they were, I heard Sam made good barks right back in there.
Oh, goddamn. One time we stood there, you could have heard 100 barks from them little bastards. Raise up on you. Here you are.
We just overrun them. We just went through damn first before we stopped. Yeah, I've done that a lot of time getting way back over and hear them back somewhere else. But I got to go back there. They've been running right there where you left. 23rd day.
You get these damn dogs you run with. They can't run fast enough to scatter their shit. We'll listen right here a minute. Right down there is where you turn them.
North?
Yeah.
Northwest.
Northwest.
Northwest over
there. I don't record that greenhouse.
No, they're fucking on here.
They are.
Yeah.
Yeah, right over there somewhere.
They've been clear up by God, the M Highway, if that is them boys.
Yeah, they have. That's right.
To get into these goddamn dogs, raising hell with them.
And I'll tell you what makes it hard to listen in here. The whole lot of these damn little dogs by half a hound.
It's so much interference.
Yeah, a lot of them half a hounds there by God. And they sound like they're...
I think that's it.
They're right there towards that damn high pole.
Oh, they've gone clear around that.
They're probably ways on over though, weren't they?
No, they're back here.
Where?
Back here.
Sound like me, it's right back over there, Comer.
Right,
I don't know where that is, but...
We'll go right over here and hit AFL.
That's where they sound like to me, right over them high poles right there. Of course, you know it's country, what I mean. That's where they sound like to us, right there to me.
I might be wrong.
That's where they sound like. They sound like, see that turf? Right there towards your house, and that's where they was, right there. Of course, that may be the way the elk echoes just stood.
Well, I saw 3 over here. That is them.
They're right back in there. That's where they was.
I'm thinking of 2 damn mini cousins.
Yeah, they might eat them dogs up, you know it?
Now they won't do that. I hate for them to get split. Hell, they won't. They'll run over one another, it sounds like, but they stay out their own coyotes.
Now, I was going to ask you that. They'll stay after a coyote, huh?
Yep.
Okay.
All these dogs might switch. They're young. God, God, their mothers wouldn't.
That's where they were. What do you think?
Oh, hell, they was clear to the other side of Gladden March.
What I mean is back in that direction. I don't, you know, I mean, you go up this road, by God, you won't be too far from it. I don't believe. That's him. We heard him out back a while ago. What he thought was a damn tree dog, too.
Yeah.
No. Well, it's, here you are. The goddamn dogs are barking clear around.
Yeah.
But it
It didn't sound like my dog.
Yeah, and the loudest one a lot of time won't be your dog a lot of the time. You better stop them about that church out there.
No, I'm going to go down. I'm going to turn here. They're coming around the other side of that.
Only when you get too far, you miss them all the time. It's better to listen and make sure that you got on course pretty good.
You stop here, you can't hear nothing.
Yeah. That's where they sound like they're resting back over there.
They come right around to you.
Yeah.
That old graveyard in there.
Uh-huh.
That was him. They're pulling right in the coyotes down there.
And they run in that grocery store.
What do you want?
Whatever you want to do. You might just stop here and just hear them come out of there, right out of there. Just turn that ass right in there. What you bet? What would you bet right there? We don't hear them dogs right there.
No, they are none.
Now when you get over here, I bet you don't hear a dog. Maybe you fool me. That's what they sound like to us, me, did you?
Over this way.
Yeah.
Right here, yeah. No, I can't.
This is
part of the old Butterfield Trail right here.
Yeah.
Actually, it really is.
Right here is where this little house
on the other side of that. Well, it's right there where they built that new house.
Yeah.
That's those, what do they call those, rain trees or something? They're the biggest ones I've ever seen. They grow in town, little tiny things. There was an old cabin there that was built about 1840s where this house is. They moved. But this is actually the old Butterfield stage line right here. Yeah.
Woman, you going too far. You missed some dogs. Sure they are.
My dog turned to miss away.
Ah, shit. You missed them as sure as shit. You're getting run away from them. I bet you are. No,
I don't hear them. We'll listen.
You too damn far away to listen. Come on now.
Oh, they done crossed that path. That was him.
That was him.
Yeah. That was him.
Them cows come out, dog.
I hope it was.
But you're going too far to hear
them.
Yeah, but you must have missed the judge. I bet you don't hear a dog here. We heard them good right there a while ago. Hell, they wasn't this far.
I don't know if that's my dog for sure.
Shit, them dogs running fine mouth dogs.
I heard
they're running.
I heard two dogs.
I heard three. I heard two fine mouth dogs. One dog got a kind of cow mouth dog.
They wasn't running. They did trailing.
Shit, if they wasn't running, by God, I'll tell you what.
But they're running. They've had time to get through here.
They may not come straight through, Comer. They might just come down there and turn and went back.
I run them in here one day, by God.
Well, they'll get over in the park here, won't they, if they come this far?
They didn't. Right, I left. Went right down the hill. I had them all caught with two. And they reported that night that they heard a woman screaming and a crying. I come over here at 10:30 and every goddamn hell they just a train on. They crossed right here, button north. And I saw three. They run in here all for hours. I sat right up here on top of the hill for shit, I don't know how long. They're on that bluff. I know right where to go to get up here. Same way. The same way, yeah. I hope to get in here. I do. But I'm afraid by God.
That was them we heard right north of us a while ago. That was them dogs right where I pointed. Over them two big red tires, man. That was them dogs right back in there. Run.
We'll hunt her all out.
They
turned back. I don't know
where they're at. Right. Had them dogs right around the house.
See, right here where they cross. And if they're on that bluff anywhere.
Well, here, stop, woman. This way you come across.
I know where we can hear them now.
Yeah, right over here.
You can hear them on this high place better than
you
can.
No, you can't.
All right. Damn, you'll turn and go back and you'll be this side of it.
Boy, no doubt where we are, smell.
Yeah.
I want to be sure I've got them dogs fast.
Stank.
Look, Wilson Creek.
Shit, Dan, I'm at home.
Yeah, but you don't know where them dogs are going.
I know where they're going to go. Three in there.
Stop.
Want to get out of here?
Yeah, get out.
Oh, big bought quail just took off over. It looks like yours are on over. This dog's at this place.
They don't do something. Why would they be down to a trail? That other dog sees him. I'll bet my fucking dog.
They split on you again.
That's killing your kisses. I don't want to go. You know, they split Saturday when I jumped. Two after one and four after one. Not the squad team. The shaddock
there.
And he called in the next morning, goddamn. These cars from Uridium Highway come in here looking for that woman, that little girl.
Oh yeah, yeah.
That old son of a bitch, they hold him. They run just like they did this one, then trail clear into the park before they jump. I don't know how in the hell they got in there. Unless they went clear around. They wouldn't have lost some bitch.
I think what they done, they swung right back in where that rock was in that, in that road and come back up at the draw. You don't make it in.
Well, now, is there one dog that leads the whole pack more or less, or they just kind of go on their own until one finds a trail and then the others come?
If they get a trail, they'll trail it out and jump it. But every place they bark, they smell cotton.
Now, by jumping, you mean that's when they see you?
Yeah, that's when they work up, they work on it.
Yeah. Okay, then they'll really chase you then.
Little sons of bitches, they get their trail by gun, you work with it, they have the other jump.
Yeah.
That's just him. Hell, they...
This fine mouth bitch there, right?
Yeah, just on. Yeah, good one.
Okay. First things first. Find him in a minute here. Now, is there a reason to carry one in the truck and turn him loose, or he just was letting him? Because he's. Back up that holler now, aren't they? Back east.
Huh? Yeah, going east.
That coyote's liable to cross here too, isn't he? Long hair. Is
There he goes, right there. Look, there he is. Right there. Hey, damn. Right across in front of it, coyote did. Yeah, right down here. There we go. He went right across there.
Hey, Dan, just be still. Right there, son. He'll come back.
Oh, listen to it echo. There they go, look at it. There they go. Well, we couldn't have been in a better place. he wasn't 50 foot away. Why, he went right just over the rise here. Went right across in front of us. And he wasn't running half as fast as they were. He was just moving right along, wasn't he? That tail sticking straight out behind him.
He'll come back about the way he done it 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
I hear by myself.
November 8th, 1975. They're coming right up here.
We want to pick them up and take them, let them loose somewhere else? Yeah. I know she don't whistle for them.
No.
You don't want them to go to other people that do, is that
no,
it?
No, it's this.
Because they'll steal them that way?
Well, yeah, they ain't going to steal them. They ain't going to train them to catch them. But, I'm afraid that scent's a goddamn dole. They don't know whether they're going right or...
Yeah.
I don't know whether I seen the back one or not. Better go right on over here on the hill. I can see better. Last 2 years ago, this son of a bitch white and every dog we got.
Maybe we'll go back to the boat range. That's where they've been.
Yep. Flip them back over, huh? What's the most dogs you've ever run at one time? I mean, in a group, even with a group of you.
Oh, I was up Walnut Grove. I imagine there's 20 or more dogs.
There they go, old Comer.
Yep, no doubt. But they didn't all run. About 15 to 15 of them run.
What's the most you usually take with you? This number, about six?
Yeah, more. I had 12. I had 12, and I sold six of them.
You didn't run all 12 at the same time?
No, but I'd go up to Coast. We'd usually run about 9 or 10 dogs.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I'd take two, had some, and at this time of year, these gentle dogs, well, that guy, how it did.
Oh, go ahead. Go ahead. Try.
On the county, and Baskets told her, taking her deer hunting, throwed her out, and hell, she wouldn't run a deer for hell. But they don't give a damn. They ain't got a collar on, that gives them an excuse if they can catch them. Well, I found her, I found her.
There's another dog right there. There she is. She's ain't too far behind.
Help!
Hell,
Mac!
Let her crawl. For a pound. They just went in that corner. Is that where they're going?
Looks like it.
Well, I mean, you know where you are better. I don't know that. There, she's there.
Hey, this way, right.
Which way?
This way.
Oh, you come out there going this way. Yeah.
Yep, they're going into the wind, aren't they?
Yeah, they're
hunting
into the wind.
Help, Matt!
Holler at her. Help, Matt! Help!
Boy, and that's people talk about a hound dog. Them hound dog got more sense. Well, a lot of people have. Now that dog knows them dog went on through. Of course, you can smell where they went through. See?
Well, that's the way wildlife and animals
get with each other.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's by scent and call.
Yeah.
Sound.
What's that now? A dog can walk a how's that? A dog can walk a coyote. Can't.
No, sir.
I mean, the coyote can walk a dog, but...
The coyote can walk any dog, but the dog can't walk a coyote.
Yeah.
They'll try it. Some of them get pretty close to it, but by God, they can't do it. They can't give it that echo.
Echo, a little funny, yeah.
Well, you take a coyote, his ears and eyes are good. That's what gets him by.
Yeah, his nose.
Well, his nose, it helps.
He can detect if anything... You can lay it out there if anything, but you don't lay with that wind, by God, and anything comes up, he'll smell it.
If you're standing, coyote can, you can just look just like a post to him, but if you raise your arms to shoot and shoot.
You go the other way, that's right. One time I seen one coming up for old boy down there, man, old King standing high the street. Well, he came with his warriors, by God, he's coming straight on. He just raised his gun, click, click. When it said click, boy, just turn, went the other way through the timber, beat anything he ever saw. And I see some hunters working over there, boy. They ain't running, are they?
What?
What is that? Is that dog running? I said, dog, right there in them cedars. Come out of the fence, throw and swung back in there. Right there in them two cedars.
She's, coming down this
yeah,
way?
Yeah, yeah. She's right there in them two cedars way over where Hickory is. And she swung one back, one of them. On which one? What? Long way to where, though.
That'd be about the one that just crossed. No. Wouldn't she be about there?
I doubt her having.
No, she got time to get there.
Right there.
She's right down here. Right in the next fence for where that big tree is. They're right on the next tree. See where it rocks in the field there?
Yeah.
It's right straight over from me.
Oh, no. I was looking over here. Yeah, I see.
Are we still a dog shark, Comer?
No.
That's all of me.
Yeah. They usually catch them like we did this morning.
Oh, they do a lot. Catch yeah. the first of these loads is caught for quite a while. That I know of.
Yeah.
They caught that Saturday. But there's just one dog, and that's this bitch, a big one that had him fighting his
yeah.
ass. She mm-hmm. barked twice. I know she had it caught. I hurried to him, and I couldn't see it. Drove around, I couldn't see a dog. It's just about 2 or 3 acres thicket. So I turned around and went back and going to go around the other side where I know it, by God, they come to me. Well, I drive up to the fence and stopped, and there every damn dog right by my truck.
They call it.
Yeah. Oh, hell, right, here you are. Man, there's no way in the world I could have caught one. I might have caught one. If they hadn't caught one, hell, I just could have gotten over there. They jumped in.
See that?
What is a smart wild animal, do you think, of all of them that you fooled with?
If here you are, a coyote, if you don't know him, I'll say he's the smartest. But experience
yeah.
teaches you to learn him. As far as people feeling like they smell steel, all that shit, well, I've seen where they piss on this, the menu. Get off of it midnight.
Yeah.
Snowed him out. Quit snowing before daylight. And got them. I tracked the coyotes right by his desk and they piss on him. They don't know what a steel rap is or nothing. They're just too dumb a hit knowing what it is. Anyway, they're suspicious of man. They're suspicious of everything that a man does. Let one throw your trap, spook him, why, make him shy. The opposite run around here, but they built another house and heard them run like hell. They don't last long. They're in that old digging hole. He's the first one they run in.
What would you guess if they were to say, come to you and say, what do you think the population of the coyotes is in this area around here? Would you even be able to guess?
It's hard to guess. I'd have to do some figuring.
Yeah. I'd
say they three dens right here at I know.
Yeah. How many miles, square miles will one pack use? Do they
some of them
get into other each other's territory, or kind of have their own territory?
Some of them like to use two or some of bitches. Would go a long ways. They could be here tonight, and tomorrow night they could be over here about every 3 or 4 nights. They just make their round and get in there. But it's gone to where they're like people. It's got to be so shit many of them.
Yeah.
They just have to stay together.
Can't get over how they're building up around here.
Oh, it's
stop here a minute. He wants to see. You got those binoculars back there.
Here you are. They should be splitting up, pairing off.
Yeah.
But this damn many of them ain't got no place to go.
Yeah.
They just stay together.
Yeah. And there's enough scrap food they can get.
Well,
from houses, do you think, or what?
Here's what's coming apart on them. Is they no farmers got out, no feeders of no kind. Farmers not feeding nothing. They can't afford to.
Yeah.
Hold it. Okay.
Feed costs too much money. And when the way it's going, when persimmons is gone, hunting season's about over with. But you got to give man credit for taking so much wildlife. Rabbits, quail. In other words, the 1st of January, the coyote is going to become hungry.
Yeah.
He's got to live. Back when we had calf feeders, we'd go up there to Polk County. I went for 2 years. I got morning or night.
And go over there to the graveyard, fair play, and throw the dogs out and go right down there to the calf feeder and start.
Hmm.
And they were there, filled up. I've shot, we'd still kill them and they wouldn't have a thing in their stomach, but turkey feed, calf feed. And there ain't no farmers got no feeders out.
Yeah. Well, what do you think they'll start doing about January then? Getting into chickens too? I mean, going closer to houses or something? Or?
There ain't many chickens.
Yeah.
You can afford to keep chickens. Yeah. Buy and keep them anywhere.
Yeah.
You seen the paper where this old boy down here at Verona went broke.
Yeah.
$2 million investment.
Yeah.
He's selling eggs cheaper than he sold them when he's getting feed $3 a hundred for feeds. Now, he's paid up to $9 a hundred for feed.
Yeah.
And it ain't right, see? You hear old Butch, everything's just like him.
Oh, yeah.
He delivered them eggs to the market. 40 cents a dozen, and the market charged 75 cents.
Yeah.
And they didn't even touch them. It's just like bread and milk. You take our supermarkets, they never touch a loaf of bread nor a bottle of milk. And right there where the big, well, hell, look at them, look at their businesses.
Yeah. Yeah, look at the size of them. That's right.
That's right.
What do you think the coyotes will do? Just starve then?
No, they won't starve. They're going to live.
What do you think they'll have? Do you think they'll become more of a problem?
I think so. Yeah. Yeah, I think so. It's coyote. Now, here you are, these. Mickey would have come and got me, but he didn't. No boy out here by Ash Grove. He said, Duke Kevin, he's down in the hill. Bags cut off. And that's what it is. It's coyotes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Coyote won't eat your ear, but a fox, that's the first thing he eats, is his ear and kits.
Yeah.
He won't eat the bag. I've never seen more fox eat the bag off.
The coyote will eat the bag.
He's goddamn too. He can cut it off slicker or off a sheep or an anti goat, and you can't cut it as slick as he can cut it with a damn any knife. I don't care how sharp it is.
Well, I'll be.
They can split a little lamb, a smaller lamb, they just split them right down the goddamn belly. You couldn't split it any straighter than they do. Just like your shirt.
Yeah.
Or a jumper. They just eat it out.
Yeah.
His front legs down to his knees, up to his head, hind legs to his hock and his tail, they leave it. Then pour, it depends on the weather, 3 to 6, 8 days, they're halfway buried. If something else don't get it, they'll come back and eat it. They eat the hoof and all. And a goddamn coyote, he ain't like anything else. He don't cheat on his feed. He just gobs it.
Yeah.
You take sheep wool, they kill a ewe. They don't spit no wool out. They just fill up on it.
Well,
and turkey feathers. I've even seen turkey feathers, tail and wing feathers, they just be folded like you can just swallow. Just a whole turd of big old feathers. It dry off, it didn't look like it ever beat.
Well, I'll be. Lord, I didn't think they could
get
them through their intestines.
Yeah, but you check where there's a lot of food, here's what'll happen. Where a coyote's eat a lot of, got a lot of food in their shit, or the other coyote'll eat it.
Well, yeah. What do you think this one has inside of him, probably?
I imagine it's persimmons and just what he can pick
up.
Damn. Right there. I don't be on the other side of that house where Munt died with me.
Where's he going?
Oh, over there?
The house, yeah, where Munt died.
Oh. Now that, who was the other fellow then?
Bill Copeland up there.
Yeah.
I think Jesse's going to take across here to the park.
We're just east of the battlefield right now, aren't we?
Park?
Yeah.
You think them cows?
About middle ways of it.
Yeah.
You think them cows in here, Mr. Owen?
Oh, yeah, I've jumped several down yonder. Hell, the day Bunt died, I jumped two. See, I had three dogs. I had Bunt, and Jesse, and Topsy, their mother. And they turned them well, and they trailed, and we had to drive out and come around. And I drove in over there. Load where they's going, and I go in over there, they just eat ass off. I took out five more dogs. They started back east. They didn't even turn around. But they whirled around. And they run in that weed patch, and by God, close near that post, they just hit one wide open.
I bet that is a madhouse.
You don't think he ain't moving too fast, Comer? Will they get through there trying to get to the next place, man?
They ain't gonna do no trailing now.
Man, where they trail at?
I say they ain't gonna do no trailing. They just win one and jump.
Was number one dog yet. Never had to do that. That's an old team guy dog. He dog can't do that for me.
The hell they can't.
They never got as much. They ain't got as much coyote sense to do that. I don't mean to say they ain't good dog, but I don't mean that.
They ain't old enough.
He's an old veteran on him. I seen him standing on his nose, work like a rabid dog in a highway. He's all an old dog, but I'm looking at him. When the cow. You want a cow brother like that, but I got an average dog, but he can run one.
You'll never own a better wolf dog than old Rudy was.
Well,
he's just too damn slow for me. If you guys are hunting him by himself, you could kill more coyotes with him. And
he's the best check dog and start dog that ever was. That's by right. God, he wouldn't run nothing off.
And mouth goddamn.
Yes. Why well, my dogs? Well, old Shanghai there was his poor brothers, wasn't he?
Yeah, little mates.
They might have been a little faster, but they never had much trail sense as he had. God damn, when it comes to the roughness, by God, he just go right through there until the rest don't go on. He went this way.
Yonder's a park.
Yeah.
They get running, we'll be way in there. I'll drive in down here. Or go around and settle over yonder. Drive in, there's a lot of them here.
Which that little jip went on with them dogs. She wasn't used to that country problem.
No.
Kind of spooked her up there.
She just got to get more.
More plain. She just don't know.
They'll be over that hill now.
Yeah.
They could. I'll get over and watch. They could come across here.
They could come across here running one, and they could turn and go back and run one, too. That's what I always think when you get kind of far out in front of them. Ain't nothing impossible because. Just like that sucker a while ago. That sucker crossed down behind us that other time.
Got us a trailer with a swimming pool.
Hey,
dude, look at that.
He's living.
He built the swimming pool and couldn't build a house. Wow. I guess that's heavy money left.
What?
Now here was a good place, wasn't it, Comer?
What?
Wasn't that a good place? Only a high glade though.
Right here is where you want to get.
Yeah. They may just come over and bust the one.
Oh boy, you can really see the hair.
Man, you could probably go in the That's one of them old priests. That's where Wolf went in the milk house, ain't it, Comer?
No.
Looks like it, don't it?
That little Kelly dog caught two down here one day. The little old Kelly dog. Back in some hell, she didn't know what to do with him. Shit. Come back, right under that tree, taking him out of doors, and we sitting there, we never got to see the cabin.
Well, it's spring up there.
Right?
There's spring up around out of the yard.
Right on top of the hill, yonder, is where they go out, but they come back a lot of time out here in the holler. These dogs are close right here. So I'm going to go on across the creek. That way we can sit over there and listen the way down. Now they go across right under that power line post on top. They don't jump. I think the dogs are close like that. They could go.
This is side from the hit one on anyway, wasn't it?
Yeah. Back up to the far end, the best. Boom.
Mac jumped one right in there one morning. Broke that son of a bitch out. Right out of his nest.
Brought him out smoking, now.
Huh?
Brought him out smoking.
The foam up there on the creek.
Huh?
Look at the foam.
You ought to see this goddamn creek here about to...
Moss and stuff. See, look at the scum.
Yeah.
That's sick. Isn't that awful? Ain't a bird who likes to step in that mud.
Ain't that awful?
Ain't an animal. Boy, right here, three meets.
Homer, I think we're going too far. We better stop right along here.
Right over here. That way I can hear clear down and clear up. We can sit here for a long time.
You think you can, huh?
Yes, sir.
What the hell was creek that thing in it? Empty in there, wasn't it?
Hell, I've seen fish in there, the hell wouldn't have
it. Well, gosh. Well, my wife's relatives used to gig bass on up in here.
Hell, I had...
I don't know where we are now. That's Nelson's Mill Road we were on, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is double F right up. Right, double Z. Double Z.
Well, where are you going to stop at, brother?
Right here at this road.
Get that long distance.
Now that's Terrell Creek comes that's in over Terrell there, Creek, and that's right. The prettiest, cleanest little stream until you get about 100 foot from Wilson Creek, and then it's there's minnows and everything until you get about 100 foot from the mouth, and then it's moss and nothing alive in it at all. Well, I've picked many an arrowhead up out of that field.
My boy's been a many Indian road to his country.
Oh, Lord, yes.
Old Jesse James. Wild Bill Hickok, I guess, all them boys.
Oh, yeah, Wild Bill. Well, that's the best I've seen that low water bridge. That's usually all washed away down there.
Last pollution meeting I went to, Sherwood Schoolhouse. I give him $5. That damn lawyer just stuck it in his pocket. They made up this $300 for him. And somebody come down Wilson Creek from that meeting and put up signs to every road, polluted water, polluted water. I had a daughter who lived on a barren spring field. A young couple with two little boys, same age. Come in here from Kansas and work for the insurance company. And they hadn't been here 5 or 6 months. No, nobody. But they found this low water bridge. They come down there and picnic and give and swim and watch the car. They thought they'd found the best place in the world.
Hold on, when you get up here, won't we just stop and listen?
We will, I will.
Right on its ride.
Somebody, that's what I said. You take up there below Springfield Lake, that damn lagoon. People picnics there, and the kids, you go up there and look right now.
Yeah.
The kid drinks that fucking water and got out of that lagoon.
Yeah.
That ought to be it.
I like you're looking at it, don't you?
They ought to jump.
Where do they come? Right over here?
They ought to.
I mean, across the creek there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, in the, on the bluff.
Yeah.
We ought to be up there top of the hill. We can hear them a lot better.
Boy, something's wrong. Can you hear him now?
Nope.
Huh?
Sound like they're looking at him. I hear him.
You hear him?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Boy, let's go back to
running, boy. Look, wait, you better wait for him. I think he's going to cross town.
Oh, hell, he's way in there. We can get back down here. We get up there, we can
run. Right, go kid, right?
Miss Gordon.
You can never see coming in here. I always try to take care of that.
Yeah, old pump, Remington pump.
No, sir. That's hey, Remington, that run, Remington that Brown. He wasn't very white for coming. Wasn't very many of them. Huh. Brown and Trump. I thought they could sell him. But I got them two girls sitting mighty close there.
You never can tell anymore if that is two girls.
You got to look at the ass, tell where they're going.
Yeah,
a lot of times.